Hi everyone, I hope you all are doing good. So I am back with another topic on progressive lenses. So today we are going to discuss about how to remark the lenses or how to check the existing fitting height and the PD of a progressive lenses. So first, let's see the basic definition. What we mean by the fitting height and what we mean by the PD. So fitting height, as you see in the picture, is nothing but the vertical measurement from bottom of the lenses to the center of the pupil. So if you see here, this is the center of the pupil. And this is from where we have to measure, and this is known as a fitting height. So in this case, we can see the fitting height is close to 24 mm. Correct? So in a simple term, if I tell you the fitting height is the vertical measurement, and fitting height is the one parameter which is bit ignored as compared to PD. So whenever we dispense a progressive lenses, we give a lot of importance to the PD, but sometimes fitting height is getting ignored and we are not giving or we are not measuring the correct fitting height. And that is one of the reasons where the progressive lenses adaptation is little less if we are not giving the correct measurement. So guys, PD is very important. Apart from that, the fitting height is also very important. When they both meet, then the fitting will be done correctly and it will match to the center of the pupil. Now coming to the PD. So PD is the horizontal distance, and most of you are aware. So PD is nothing but if you take the center of the nose to the center of the pupil. So this is known as the PD. So ideally, we generally prefer to have the monocular PD than binocular PD. So monocular PD will give you the more precise fitting for each eye. And if you take the binocular PD and you divide by two, then this is the wrong practice. Because in majority of the cases, the PD will not be the exact divided by two. So suppose in the given picture, if it is 60 mm, and then you divide by 2 and it will come 30-30, then there is a high chances that will give you the wrong fitting, right? So PD is the horizontal distance from center of nose to the center of the pupil. Now let's understand how the progressive lenses is fitted in a frame, right? So what is there in the progressive lenses? This fitting is a bit technical as compared to the single vision and the bifocal lenses. So guys, if you see the progressive lenses, these are the hidden markings on the progressive lenses which you generally don't see once the progressive lenses is fitted in the frame, right? So we should know what are all the marking is there in the progressive lenses. So whenever we remark the progressive lenses, we will have that in our mind. So you can able to see there are two type of marking. One is in the red color and one is in the gray color. So gray color is known as the permanent marking. That means that marking will be there on the lenses till the customer is using. It might be 2 years old lenses, 3 years old or 4 year old lenses. It doesn't matter. That marking will be there on the lenses, right? The red color marking, whatever you are seeing, that is used for the fitting purpose. And after the once the lenses is fitted on the progressive lenses, that will be erased. And the lenses which you see, it's just like a single vision lenses without any marking, right? So this red color marking, one is a distance reference point. So which is, so all your distance power will be there in that circle. After that, there is a fitting point, or which will also what is a fitting cross. So this cross should match with the center of the pupil. Then we will have a prism reference point, which is just below the fitting cross, and it varies from 2 to 4 mm of the distance. Then we will have a near reference circle, right? So near reference circle will be our power will be covered within this near reference point, right? So this is all called as a temporary marking. That means once the lenses is fitted in the frame, this all marking will be erased. Okay. Then we will have a permanent marking, which is the micro etching. So if you see, there's a dot. So there's a two dots. So this is known as a micro etching. And then we will have an add. That means whatever the addition you are prescribing, you can able to see. And then we will have a logo. So all the lens manufacturing company will have their own logo for their progressive lenses. So today what we are going to measure is the fitting height. So this blue arrow which you are seeing, that means the center or the fitting cross to the near reference circle. So this is called as the fitting height. And this is we will measure how to measure this. So this is how the progressive lenses look. So whatever the marking we discuss, this is a distance reference circle, this is a fitting cross, so micro etching, right? So 1.56 is the index and the logo and the near reference circle. So whenever you order any progressive lenses, so once the lenses is ready, you will see the lenses like this. Now, after the lenses is fitted on the frame, so this is all the parameter, guys. So this is how, so this is the fitting point. So this should match with the center of the pupil, right? This is the near reference circle. So this should cover inside the frame. If it is not covered inside the frame, that means my near reference circle is not in the right position and customer or the patient might face problem in the reading, right? So in this case, if you see the distance from the fitting prism reference point to the near reference circle is 14 mm. And from fitting cross to the prism reference point is 4 mm, right? So fitting height is somewhere around 18 mm, right? And the distance between two micro etching, right? So this is one micro etching, this is one micro etching. So ideally, this should be in the straight when the lenses is fitted. Right, so if you see, this is in the straight line, and the distance between these two micro etching is a 34 mm, and exactly at 17 mm. That means you see 17 mm, exactly at 17 mm in between you will have a prism reference point, and above the prism reference point you will have a fitting cross. Right, so once this all is done, so whatever the lenses you will see when it is fitted and it will come to you, and the, when customer use, it will be like this. It will be a plain lenses. You will see some amount of the blurry vision in the periphery of the lenses, and there will be no marking you can able to see from the outside or with a naked eye, right? So this is how the progressive lenses anatomy is there and how you will look the progressive lenses. So generally, when the customer is using the progressive lenses, it will be something like this, right? So we have seen from the starting, whatever is the marking in the progressive lenses, how it looks, how it is fitted. But when the final product comes to you, the final product will look like this. So there will be no marking on the lenses, right? So now it becomes important ki once there is no marking on the lenses, it all has been erased. Now, if the customer come with a troubleshoot or when you are doing the QC, how you will remark the lenses when there is nothing on the lenses? So let's see how you will remark the lenses. So what is the requirement to measure the fitting height or the PD is the temporary marker. So you should have the temporary marker, right? You have a ruler and you should have a layout chart. So with the help of these three things, and the fourth thing is your skills, right? And your experience. So these four things, if you have, you can remark the progressive lenses and the fitting height. Now, when to measure? So we have to measure the fitting height and the PD during the quality check of the progressive lenses. That means once you ordered the progressive lenses, it came to you and now you are going to give it to the customer. So before giving it to the customer, we will do a quality check. So before, in the quality check, we will look in all the markings that whatever is the ordered, as per the order, that has been done or not. So we will check the power, we will check the micro etching, whether it's in the straight line or not. We will check the fitting height. Suppose you have ordered for the fitting height of 21. So 21 is there or not. We will measure the PD. Suppose if you ordered the PD of 31 and 30, if it is fitted on 31 and 30 or not. If any of the parameters is not matching, then you have the right to reject the lenses under the quality check. Now the second time when we have to do all these things is when the customer comes to you and he is telling, I'm not comfortable with the progressive lenses, right? So when the customer is not comfortable with the progressive lenses, so you should know what went wrong. And to know what went wrong, you have to remark the progressive lenses, right? And it is always recommended to check the customer existing PD and fitting height of his old glasses before dispensing the new pair of the progressive lenses. So whenever you go to the tailor, so whenever the tailor is taking the measurement, he always take the measurement with your existing cloth, whatever you are wearing, right? They will take the reference with that, correct? So this is the three or four situation where you have to remark the progressive lenses. And when you don't know how to remark the progressive lenses, then it will become very difficult to do all these things. Now, what is the step one, right? So step one is to, you have to take the frame on which the progressive lenses is fitted. Then you have to put under any lighting condition. And when you see the lenses under any light, you will see the two dots like this, right? So, and this two dot is known as a micro etching or water points. So this two dot can be in the form of circle. It can be in the form of a triangle. It can be in the form of a plus, right? So once you see this dot or plus or the triangle, what you have to do with the help of the marker, you have to put a small dot on that, right? So you will have a two dot on one lenses, and on the another lenses, again, you will have a two dots, right? So when you see this, your half work is done, right? So if you see here, this is in the straight line, and ideally it should be in the straight line. If it is not straight, then there is something wrong in the fitting. Now, after the remarking, what you will have, you will have a layout chart. And this is known as a marking chart or the layout chart. And in this layout chart, you will have a two circle. One is for the right lenses and another one will be here for the left lenses. So on this layout chart, already there will be a marking done, right? So you will see two micro etchings, which is already marked. So what you have to do, we have already remarked the lenses with the help of the two micro etching. You will have a lens on the lenses. So what you have to do, just take the lenses and put on that or align with that plus mark and this marking which you have done on the lenses. So once this is aligned, you will have a plus mark which is there on the marking chart. So just with the help of the marker, you have to draw the plus mark on the lenses. So now you will get the fitting cross, right? So with the help of the marker and with the help of our skills, we have remarked the two things which we have saw in the first slide of the anatomy of the progressive lenses: fitting cross, micro etchings, and the near reference circle, right? So if you see here, the distance reference circle is also covered in the frame, right? The near circle is also covered in the frame. Micro etching is in the straight line. So this is the ideal fitting, right? So there is no problem in the fitting, right? So now after we remark the progressive lenses, when we get the fitting cross, so what you have to do here, you have to take the normal ruler, just coincide with this and measure from the fitting cross to the inside of the rim, right? So now in this case, if you see, this is 22 mm, right? So the fitting height for the lenses is 22 mm, right? So we can find out the fitting height once the lenses is fitted. So we have remarked all these things and we came to the correct fitting height. Now, after both the lenses you have marked, you can also find the PD, on what PD it is fitted. So you have to take the layout chart and you can see many triangles here, right? So what you have to do, you have to coincide the triangle apex in the middle of the bridge, right? So the center of the bridge should be placed at the triangle apex, right? So once you do this, you find key, there are many numbers written here with, on the layout chart, and that numbers will coincide with the fitting cross. So in this case, in the right lens, if you see, the PD is 35 and in the left eye it is 33, right? So guys, this is how we will find the PD and the fitting height for the fitted lenses on which the progressive lenses is fitted, and we have to find whatever the parameters which we have given, it is fitted on that or not. So assume we have given the fitting height of 22, we have cross checked, it is fitted on the 22, we have ordered the PD of 35 and 33, when we cross check, it is fitted on the 35 and 33, the micro etchings are in the straight line, right? So the fitting is also proper, right? And the distance reference circle, near reference circle is also covered in the frame. So as per me, this is a QC pass lenses, right? And the power is also correct. But any of the parameter is not matching. Suppose you have ordered the fitting height of say 19, but it came to 22. It can be a QC fail lenses. You have ordered a PD of 35, but when you remark the lenses, it is 30. It is a QC fail lenses, right? And if you don't have the layout chart also, still you can find out the PD with the help of the ruler, right? So let's practice on the few progressive lenses today and make a note of the fitting height and the PD. And guys, the most important part is that if you don't want to forget the today's session or anything which you learn, then what you have to do, you have to practice and you have to teach someone. So when you teach someone, trust me, you will never forget this. And the third thing is you have to implement it. So I hope you will like this today's session, which was a small topic, but it is very important, because in most of the cases, whenever a customer come with a troubleshoot and whenever a customer come with a complaint, we fail to solve the customer problem because we don't know how to remark the lenses, right? And this is very important. So in the next session, we will see more of the troubleshoot, and let's wait for the next session. Thanks to you for your valuable time.